There are a few different ways to create pillars and other circular shapes in TrenchBroom. One way is to use the complex brush tool and click out points on your grid and then extrude that shape. See below for a link to the brush tool tutorial if you haven't seen it. Another way would be to make a brush and then use the clip tool to shave off the edges. But recently I've come across a brilliant method that a number of mappers are using. Jazz Mickle was kind enough to illustrate it for me, and now I'm passing this method on to you. This technique uses a few functions I haven't gone over before, but eventually we'll cover them in much more detail. In a nutshell, we're going to make a series of brushes and merge them together to form a column shape. So let's begin. Step one is to determine the diameter you want your pillar. I'm going with 64 units. You'll also want to know how many sides you want the pillar ahead of time. I want a pillar with 12 sides total. You'll want to use a grid of 16 for this, and for smaller shapes, smaller grid sizes. Now, make a diamond shape using the complex brush tool. Make sure the longest ends of your diamond are 64 units apart. It's a good idea to isolate this brush now. You'll see why in a minute. Ctrl+I will isolate the brush. Now we're going to utilize TrenchBroom's excellent repeatable commands function. What this does is repeat a list of commands to speed up editing. You can use this to make stairs, copy and paste items, and all kinds of repetitive tasks. So first, we need to reset the command list by pressing Shift+Ctrl+R. You can also find this in the Edit menu. Next, press R to enter the Rotate tool, and then Ctrl+D to duplicate the brush. Grab the blue Rotate handle and rotate the duplicated brush by 30 degrees. Here's where the repeatable commands come in. I'm hitting Ctrl+R four more times. Now we have a total of 6 overlapping diamond shapes. Press Ctrl+A to select all the brushes, and then Ctrl+J to merge them together using CSG Merge. That can be found in the Edit menu as well. Here's our 12-sided, 64-unit pillar. However, there are some errors in the issue browser. It reads, "Brush has non-integer vertices and plane points." These could cause issues when you compile your map, so it's just best to fix them now. Select your new brush, and in the Edit menu, choose Snap Vertices to Integer. The shortcut is Ctrl+Shift+V. Now you can see the errors have gone away. One last thing you'll want to do is reset the texture in the Face Inspector window. There's no keyboard shortcut, so click this little icon here to reset your texture. So that's it for the basics. A couple of tips though. If you want a 24-sided brush, rotate your diamond shape by 15 degrees. And if you want just 8 sides, rotate the brush by 45 degrees. Now let's look at this 12-sided column in-game. Notice the harsh shadows that are caused here. Now you may want this look, and that's fine, but if you wanted smoother shading, there's a way to do this using the Fong shading feature in Eric W's tools. So back in TrenchBroom, I'm going to select the brush, right-click, and make the brush a Funk detail. Now the brush is an entity. In the Entity Inspector, we'll need to add a new key called Fong and give it a value of 1. That turns on the Fong shading for this brush. I've recompiled the map, and now you can see that gorgeous shading thanks to Eric W's tools. I'd suggest making a bunch of different shapes and sizes of these columns and then saving them to a separate map file. You can open 2 different copies of TrenchBroom and copy and paste them into your maps. That's it for pillars. Thanks for hanging in there. We'll see you in the next tutorial.